And welcome to lockdown vlog number 14. Another week in lockdown is starting. So this is the view for today. Apparently we have a little rain this afternoon and then 14 days of no rain. And fortunately I do not have a garden. So last week, last Friday, happening here, yeah. The Willsenton is now standing right over there. You all have seen the review. I got some very nice comments on them and also some questions, and I realized, well, there were some things that I was planning to put into the video, and at the end, because of time, it did not happen. There were questions like, well, what is a boogie factor? And I realized I was going to explain that, but I didn't. So to pick out this one, boogie factor for me means if the system wants you to get up and dance, give you that feeling, tapping your feet as soon as the music is starting. So for now, I temporarily, probably only today and tomorrow, I have this Quad 99 set. What I am going to do this week is to restore my original system, so get the Ocellias back, fire up the Itos OTL mono power amps, and have a listen to my old system again. Alright, one of the reasons I got into a time squeeze for filming the footage for the Willsenton is because I already did a lot of shooting on my phone, but my phone was dying a little bit on me, and you probably heard in some of my videos the ticking noises. That was a problem of the phone. So when I changed to my new camera, I thought, well, this looks much better. So I had to, I didn't have to, but I did. I reshoot a lot of the footage, and that got me a bit of a time squeeze at the end. But anyways, thank you for your nice comments on that. Over here, you have not seen these two little loudspeakers. These are two Elac loudspeakers. I use them in my desktop setup. They are the BS52. Apparently somebody thought calling a loudspeaker BS is a good thing. But anyways, they have a nice connection so you can hang it on the wall. And the reason I have them over here is when I have a new device coming up here, especially if I do not know if it is working or not, and especially when it is a power amp, what I will do is I will connect everything. I will use the Elacs to connect to the system, and I will play it. So in case when something goes wrong and the loudspeaker get damaged, it is only the Elacs that got damaged. And these are the cheapest loudspeakers I have in my house. Or let me rephrase that. These are the cheapest loudspeakers in my house that I do not care about if they get damaged. I believe I paid 20 euros for them. These are nice, but not very interesting. There's one thing which is very interesting about the Quad 99. And in order to explain why and why I like that, I'll take you downstairs again. You know by now, downstairs I have my man cave. And I always walk by on the stairs, and I always keep up with the amount of subscribers. So 663 for today. I showed you already this quad set, which is a lot older than the set upstairs. I love this quad set. But what is the thing over here? Well, you can have a radio connected, so this is the radio, so that spot is taken. You can have a what's it called, a record player over here. Then you can then you can connect one CD player and one tape deck, and that's it. So in order to be able to connect more devices to this equipment, I have this little switch box, which is a great little thing, and this gives me 5 inputs and 1 output, and the 1 output goes over here. So if you have your tuner connected, you have your tape deck connected, you have your record player connected, then I only have left 1 input being used for this switch box. So actually you can get only 1 thing extra. Now let me take you back upstairs, looking at why, what did they do different in the Quad 99 series. Well, here you have it. So over here we have the tuner. I'm not using the tuner, so what I have here is a CD player, a preamplifier, and a power amplifier. And what I can do with only these 3, I could connect up to 11 devices to this 3 setup. So if I wanted to, I don't know why I would want to, but if I wanted to, I could add 9 extra CD players to this little setup. I could add a record player and another tuner, even when the other tuner is connected in this set, I could also add another tuner. So in total I can add up to 11 devices to this little setup, and the sound is very good. Now, to be honest, 6 of them need to have a digital output which will be connected to the CD player. Also, I could remove the preamp and have the CD player directly connected to the power amp, because this one also acts as a preamp, and then I could also connect another 6 digital inputs. So this is pretty neat if you have, if you want to use many different objects, devices. Now of course I have my main my main system, so why would you need anything else other than that? Well, the thing is, you get used to your own system, but in order to really know what actually is the quality of your system, you need to listen to a lot of different other devices, preferably in the spot that you are listening to your own setup. So if you would go to a hi-fi shop, I mean, the cables would be different, the acoustics will be different, so there's all kind of things that will be different. But this, apart from secondhand being, if you get lucky, I was lucky and then I paid the price for a stack of this, but these go for double the price also at this moment on Craigslist. But that's not what I'm doing. So for relative easy money, little money, you can have a great system, because this also has a very, as a sound potential, this thing sounds great. And especially I'm in love with the CD player and the quality of the sound of the CD player. So there probably will be a review of this, a retro review of this whole set, including the tuner. So what else was I going to tell? Well, maybe that's all for today. At the moment I'm playing some classical music. If you would like to hear a good recording, let me see if I can put this one up for you. Try to find this recording. This is really, really very good recording. So to finish up for today, make sure that you watch tomorrow. I have a little surprise for you tomorrow, and I may have a little surprise for you further on in this week, because I still don't feel like this lockdown is going to finish this week. So we'll just keep on going on and make a video for you guys every day. Make sure, as I told you yesterday, if you want to help me, give it a thumbs up and make sure you watch the whole video, because the Google YouTube will decide if it tells other people to watch my video based on thumbs up and time watched. So if you want to help, that's how you can help. Make sure to watch tomorrow, and I'll see you tomorrow.